Minling.
Useful gadgets I have. Yes, I do.
Yes? What is it that you want exactly? If you want to buy something, then say so quickly, but because I've got little enough time to spare for the likes of you. What do you know about what's going on in this village? Nothing. And I don't want to know nothing. All I want is to be able to get out of this stinking village safely once the roads are open. Merchant can't even make a decent living here. Alright, let me see what you have in stock then. Fine. But don't touch anything unless you're planning on buying it. My. Selling a gem bag. Some potions of frost giant strength. Does a 21. I think I'll save my money for now. The Tranion's Baylor Ale, brewed with pimentos for that extra little kick. Kind of seems like a quest item, doesn't it? I think we have one, though. Yeah, I have one here. Alright. Beherent Deer?
You'll find no better prices in Arm. I guarantee it.
I just know that one of these days, one of those ogres is going to come down and massacre me, just like those other villagers. I never thought of something like this when I became a merchant. What do you know about these killings? Oh, it's a terrible thing, isn't it? People dying left and right? You can hardly find a customer anymore, and it's probably okay, because no one will restock me now anyway. Somebody should do something about those ogres, though. Ever since they came, it all started. One of my caravans once got attacked by ogres. They're evil and brutal. Alright, can I see what you have in stock? I would suppose so, but there isn't much. Caravans just won't come here unless they're stocked with guards, and that doesn't make it very profitable now, does it? I suppose not. We don't need any of this crap. Alright, we're done with the little merchant square here in the inn. Johanna's here, and Ander, and a book merchant. Is she still busy?
Well met and welcome!
I don't see what all the fuss is about. 'Tis the ogres who've been killing everyone. That's what monsters do. Ander?
Bloke can't walk 5 feet these days without someone hitting him up.
We ain't fond of strangers here at the moment. There's been too many of the villagers gone missing, there has. Book merchant.
Well, you look like the sort who has more than 2 gold pieces to rub together.
Sorry, ain't got much in the way of tomes today. Been real slow here, so I shipped most of my stock to Athkatla. Ain't talked to anyone in weeks, actually. Business been that bad because of the nasty events around here recently? Aye, that it has. Though there have been quite a few old books turning up around here to make it worthwhile. Nothing startling, but I get by. Enjoy your stay as best as you can under the circumstances.
Have a look at my wares. I trust you'll find them all in satisfactory condition.
Fare you well and whatnot. Be sure to stop by. Always a friendly word for good listeners. Well, I wanted to buy some books from you, but you said you had a few. Odds are they're probably something we already have. Sleeping woman.
Trust is for the foolish and the dead. I shall follow
what?
Your strength.
Fine.
Why can't we close these doors?
Fleet of foot and all that.
Such menial tasks.
Faster than Chiktika fast paws.
Yoshimo is willing.
Oh. Guess we were in the way.
All the world is blood. You're right behind me, right?
Four 10 gold and a gold ring. Sleeping woman has nothing to say. I wonder why that would be. I'm kidding, guys. I'm kidding. Alright.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Oh, there's that little Willet the stable boy. I don't know if we can walk back here from here. It is, okay.
Who are you?
Unless you got yourself a horse hidden under all that there armor, you should be talking to Vince and not me, aye? Well, you got a point. What? Umor Witch Project Journal. All identical. Oh, I got one. Oh, that's the same. Oh, there's two. There is two boxes. So we have a lot of these journals. I'm assuming they're all the same. Up here, too. Is the boy watching us? I think the boy's watching us. There's more of them. That's a lot of books.
I am ready, I think.
Very well. Hiya.
Nature, I am willing.
All the world is your cutter.
Let's hope this is okay.
Destiny awaits.
Nothing dangerous.
Yeah, no one's coming after us, so. Definitely need some more of those.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time. Stand back for justice.
We'll talk to him last when we're ready to go sleep. Right now we're just wandering around. Talking to everybody and seeing what there is to see. Where'd that go? Oh, I want to look at this book. This journal seems to be that of an apprentice mage, telling the tale of her expedition into the Umor Hills with two other apprentices in the search for evidence of the fabled witch. The tale is hard to believe, but seems to relate the group's horror at getting lost and being hounded by an unseen predator during the nights. The script is in a panicky, feminine hand, and the last page can barely be made out as follows. Sorry to Joshelis's mother. I'm sorry about what happened to Michaelis. There's something out here with us. We thought it to be peasants, but peasants aren't this clever. Joshelis says it's the witch. I hear her when I sleep. I don't want to sleep. I don't want to sleep. I don't want... The journal ends here. Huh. I can't copy the note like we can with like all the other texts. But I can put it in there. Very curious.
What do you need?
I can dance on the head of a pin as well.
I want to make sure that they're all the same. Yeah, they are. So if it's a journal, someone's like printed up copies of an almost illegible journal? It just doesn't make sense. Weird. Alright, what is to
every
here?
Every hamster, see battle bow. Run, bow, run!
Going out. Here's Dar. And a door. Dar and a door.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Hello, Dar?
Hmm?
Oh, greetings to you, stranger. Who are you? My name is Dar, and I am no one of importance, I suppose. At least, nobody important enough that my love's father might vaguely consider allowing me to court her. No? Why not? My love is Colette, and her father is a wizard of no small power and possessed of considerable bias against me. Is his name Valigar? Corthala? Oh no, his name is Germian. I understand he tends to use Colette as a bargaining tool for some wizardly endeavor of his own. Against her will, I imagine, although I've had no chance to ask her opinion. I know she wants to go with me, I know it, but her father will have none of it. He intends to go to great lengths to keep us apart. Oh, woe is me. I could remove your father from the equation for a prize. Don't be a wimp. Okay. Perhaps I could... kill him? Perhaps I could speak to him for you. It would be of no use, I am sure, and I do not wish to use violence in such an endeavor. I do not appreciate its taste, and I doubt Germian would... And no doubt Germian would crush me with magic. You were kind to offer your assistance, but there is no helping me, I think. Leave me to my sorrow, please. Huh.
I am at peace in the outdoor places, though it never seems to last.
Well, that's Germian's home. Oh, that's the wizard's home, right there. Okay. Let's just go take a peek up here. Catch ya? Oh, the herders and stuff are over here.
You're a stranger.
Hello, sir. Who might you be? My name's Katya. I came here with me ma and pa to flee the bad people who are killing everybody. When I grow up, though, I'm gonna be a mighty warrior and leave this place for good. What do you know about these bad people? Ma and pa says I'm just telling stories, but I'm not. It's true, and I really saw it. I was bringing the cows home a couple of weeks ago, but I was bringing them through the path in the woods because it's faster, even though ma doesn't like it when I goes through there. But I pass us by the ranger's cabin. Marilla's always been real nice to me. She gives me candies that she says she makes out of tree sap, and she took me fishing once, too. When I passed by it, though, I saw this big black shadow coming out of her cabin, and it was leaving a big trail of red stuff, which looked like blood. It was so big and scary, it looked like a wolf monster. I was so scared for Marilla, so I went and told me Ma and Pa, but they didn't believe me, told me to stop telling stories. But it really is true, sir. Honest. If you went to the cabin, I bet you'd find something. It's just to the west of the village, out in the valley. Nobody wants to go out there now because they're all scared. But I know I saw something, sir. Okay, bye. Alright, the herder and the...
My thieving skills would be of little use here. What wealth does a bear drop in the woods?
I don't know. You might have to piece through some bear droppings to go find it.
Top of the day to you.
Aye? Is there something that you want? Who are you? Well, my name's Dale. I do some herding out in the fields with the cows and such with my wife. Me wife here and me kids. Came into the village. Just ain't safe anymore out there. I knows two other herders who vanished. And the farmers ain't safe, neither. Farmer Jacob and his wife were both slaughtered, and then their bodies disappeared. Terrible things all. What can you tell me about these killings? Well, it's some ogres, sure enough. You get monsters in the area, you get killing in the area. Me wife think it's the wolves, but that's just foolish talk. Wolves would go after the cows, right? And we have had no more killing of the cows than we've had since the wolves showed up a couple years back. People gets hysterical, they does. Groose there babbles on about that witch, and me daughter Katya is no better with her stories. You should hear her, heh? We did. It's the ogres, and they'll come and finish us all off once they've picked us clean to small enough numbers. We should be fleeing as soon as we can, true enough. You just watch yourself around here. Them ogres will be the death of us all, they will. Hmm.
Good business to you.
Don't go into the hills, though. Just a friendly warning. Dale? Oh, Gruz. Hello? Don't meet a lot of strangers around here, especially as of late. Who are you? Name's Gruz. Came into the village with some of the other herders after some of us started being slaughtered. Or just plain disappeared. Herders, farmers, anyone in the outlying lands. The mayor sent some people out to find out what's happening, but I know what's going on. It's Umar. The witch has come back, and there ain't no one who goes into the hills going to come back now. Umar? She's a powerful old witch. Ruled these hills over 500 years ago. Disappeared. No one knows where to. But she's come back, that's for sure. People around here, they don't believe me, I know. But they don't go deep into the hills where I go. Late at night, you hear things not of this world. And it makes you believe anything is possible. If you don't believe me, go and ask Vincenzo at the inn. He knows more about Umar than anybody. Yeah, I talked to him. Okay. Margie?
And who might you be?
Hello, my lord. It's a bad time you picked to visit our fair village. Who are you? My name is Margie, short for Margaret. My husband is Dale, one of the herders. We fled from the outskirts of the village lands because of the wolves.
Wolves?
The wolves have picked this year to start in on us people, mauling and stealing corpses. It has just been ghastly. They've been around for several years, but they've never been this bad. Everyone got so upset and frightened, and they start thinking things are happening that aren't. Some people are blaming the ogre and his band, but they haven't done anything to harm us. After all, how can an ogre steal into the village and steal a body? No. And tales of Umar are just fanciful. Even my daughter, Katya, hears these things and comes up with wild stories. The wolves around here have always been a danger. They're large and they're smart. And they're just a danger once again. That's all there is to it. People should know better. I think I believe the kid out of anyone. Good luck to you then, my lord. Ada?
Who are you?
I heard that ranger woman Mirella is a vampire. She's gone and started prowling the night, stealing bodies. Here's Jeb, standing over by himself.
Weather's been lousy lately.
Fine thing, us all fleeing into the village from our farms, for all the good it'll do us. Don't know how you fools can wander around in all your metal get-up in this heat. I don't know why we want to threaten him. Just the price of being an adventurer, my good man. Adventurers, are you? Heh, I'll give you an adventure you won't soon forget. For a few golders, mind you. Golders, is it? Will 10 gold pieces be enough for you? 10 golders? Nay, metalhead, this one's worth at least 30. I'm gonna buy an adventure from him? You'd think I was buying iron. Will 20 gold pieces satisfy your penny lust, old man? Sure. You see, those folks in town with all the chickens? 'Tis the farmer Hendrick and his wife. Fled here from their lands just like I have. His daughter was a tomfool, tin-head adventuring type just like you. Died young just this past season. Still with me? Good. Then I won't have to repeat myself. Not long after she died, a bunch of other tinheads came looking for her, said she had something of theirs. Heh, old Hendrick just took him outside and pointed to her grave marker and told him to get the hell off his land, 'cause they had something of his, too. So that night, I heard a ruckus in his hen house, looked out the window, and there he was trying to stuff something down a gullet of one of them chickens he keeps out back. Draw your own conclusions, friend, but I'm thinking there's something a tin head like yourself might like buried deep in the gizzard of one of them cluckers. If you can think of another reason why they fled to the town with their chickens and nothing else? I'll be glad to hear it. Now clear off before you bake in them there ovens of honor you got on you. Well, at least it's the middle of the night. There's a what in their chicken? Does it go to the bottom? No. I don't know what the... I guess it's a predetermined way that these show up. A farmer named Jeb told me that the Hendricks, fellow farmers who have fled from the outlying lands into Imnisvale, may have put something down the gullets of one of their chickens, something their adventuring daughter brought home with her before she died. Considering the Hendricks went through that much effort to hide it, it may be something quite valuable. Mm-hmm. How's the adventure coming? Thanks for the extra golders, by the way. All right. So over here, we've got some more people. Derbert, Valspin, and Neller.
Wow, an adventurer.
Ma'am? My name is Derbert. Me and my friends here want to be adventurers like you. Real strong and powerful-like. Valspin says, yeah, I want to be a ranger and protect the village. Neller says, I want to be a great warrior like me dad. Derbert says, I know as we can, but everyone says we're all too young and all. Neller says, bull, that's what I says to that. Derbert says, since you're already an adventurer and all, ma'am, I was hoping you might maybe buy some swords for us, some bastard swords. Valspin says, and some ale, Derbert, don't forget the ale. I don't think you're of legal drinking age. Yeah, we wants to be real men, says Neller. Derbert says, swords and some ale, then. If we give you the money, ma'am, would you buy us some? I'm afraid they're gonna get hurt. They're gonna go out adventuring, even if we just get them ale? I'll buy you ale, boys, but you just cut yourselves with a sword in your hands. No, we wouldn't, Derbert says. We know how to use swords, but if you buy us some ale, that'd be super. Here's some gold we've saved up for it. Aw, this bites. I wanted a sword, says Neller. Valspin says, but your ma should be mad if you hacked off an arm. Me, I want the ale. Sissy, says Neller. We're buying kids ale? Idle hands in Imnisvale. I've agreed to buy some ale for three boys in the Umara Hills village. They wanted swords and I said no, but I'm not about to refuse the boys a good time. One of the local merchants should have what they need. How old are these kids, though? So, have you got our stuff? I guess, yeah, I'm giving the ale that's in the bag of holding we looked at. Yes, I've got a keg of ale for you here. I'll bail our ale. Wow, you're the greatest, ma'am. Yay, let's go drink now. Drink it now. You got experience. Derbert says, I know a place. Come on. Well, I bought the three kids in Imnisvale what I promised them, and they've run off to enjoy it. Hopefully they don't get into too much trouble. Here's to hoping their parents don't get wind of this. Yeah, maybe that's one quest I should have refused, right? Okay, we're gonna leave the evil wizard house alone for now. Oh, there's more people. Hendricks? Oh, there's the chickens they were talking about. Anna and Erlin.
helmet and welcome.
Is this something you'd be needing me, Lord? What can you tell me about all these murders? We fled all the death and murders, me and my Erlin. 'Tis no longer safe out in the farms, but I know nothing else about it. The chicken has nothing to say. How rude. How much are you asking for those chickens? They aren't for sale. I'll hack them apart until I find what I want. Oh my god. Are you sure? I could offer a good price for them. Talk to Erlin if you wish to discuss the chickens, my lord. I'll have nothing to do with it. Interesting. Erlin!
I've no time for to talk to you now.
What the forests in the north look like from the sky. They're so majestic.
Yeah, majestic. We're just good folk fled from the outer farmland, stranger. We ask nothing of you other than you leaves us be. What can you tell me about the murders here? Just start with some small talk. I can tell you nothing. We're just frightened and wants nothing but to go home again. Just leave us be, my lord. How much are you asking for the chickens? I'll buy them off you. They're not for sale. Are you sure? I can offer a good price for them. What are you implying, stranger? I said they're not for sale. I know there's something valuable in one of those chickens, and I'm willing to buy it off you, is all. I suppose it's best not to be hanging on to it any longer. Eventually someone will come and take it from us. What can you pay me for it, my lord? Well, I don't know what it is. I mean, we do have a lot of money. I'll give you 50 gold pieces for it. Aye, you're more than fair, I suppose. Take it, then. Me wife and I shall find some other way to remember our daughter. A Belgerl? Oh, we just bought a gem from him? I purchased a Belgerl gem from a farmer in Imnisfail who had hidden it from thieves inside one of his chickens. I paid the man a fair price, for which he was glad. Apparently his adventurer daughter has paid for the gem with her own life. That's sad. Damn. I wouldn't have even bought it. Normally a deep, pleasant seawater green, Belgerls periodically blaze with a glittering, winking, flashing light. However, this particular stone has a slightly different hue. Perhaps it is a new strain, rarely if ever seen before. It looks incredibly valuable. Maybe we'll find a use for it, or we can sell it back or something. Well, we don't have to rip apart chickens. Always a good thing. There's a deer over there. Is there anything to fight here? We did find a deer, and where there's deer, there can be other animals. There's a moose. Moose and squirrel. With an added rabbit. Groundhog. Over here, we have nice animals. What is this place? Ranger Cabin. Shadows? Ugh. So this might be effective. Holy smite, I believe. Spell's area of effect. I guess we should wait until they close. Don't kill the groundhog. Hopefully we can target them. They kind of look invisible-ish. Let's try this holy smite. They're all shadows and shadow fiend. Oh, it hurt Viconia. That's our answer to that question.
Armored, sharpened, and raring to go.
And she is also evil.
Your life,
my husband is faulty.
All right. Oh, he's drained. Alright. We can have a fix for that. Lesser restoration? Okay, I guess we needed greater restoration.
How long do you intend to crack your whip on my back? I say stop now.
What's lesser? We have lesser here too. So where is greater restoration? Well, I don't know what else to do for him at this point. Oh, there's a lot to this area. Okay. Before we do anything else, let's go back and rest. I think we're taking the long way around, but that's alright. People came out here now.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Vincenzo!
Never had rats.
No sirree. Hello to you and a good day. I am Vincenzo and I offer you all the services of me humble little inn. Willet, the stable boy, says, "There are a lot of things to be said about your inn, Vince, but humble ain't the one I would be picking, aye?" "Hush, boy, and keep calling me Vince, and I'll have you strapped or a log. The name's Vincenzo." "That's a lot of rot. He hears that name from a Symbian trader, and suddenly you're putting on airs." "Pfft. Never mind the boy. He's an ignorant lout you took in out of pity. A simpleton who doesn't know his place. Is there aught I can do for you, my good lord?" "What do you know about the killings around here?" "Ah, Vincenzo knows the truth. My family has been in this here area for a long, long time, and the tales of the witch, Umar, have been passed down, they have." Willet says, "You're not going to go into that rot again, are you?" "Silence, boy. Perhaps I should give you to the witch instead, as an offering, eh? Leave you on the doorstep with a lace of garlic tied around your neck?" "Well," the boy says, "I thought that'd shut your trap. Now then, me lord, I can tell you about the witch Umar, a tale sure to curl your ears, if you'd care to hear it." "Go ahead, I've got the time." "Like I said, me family has been around these parts a long time. We were here back when the witch herself plagued these lands over 700 years ago. Umar was a wicked one. No one ever saw her except when she came down from the hills to steal some unfortunate soul. Shepherds, babes, anyone who weren't careful. She'd torture them. You could hear their cries during the night. People tried to find her, but only the victims' bodies would turn up, mutilated and dead." Well, it says, "Don't know why they just didn't kill her." "Because they couldn't find her, you stupid boy. Were you not listening? And besides, she were a powerful witch with plenty of magic for any fight. Strange thing is, me lord, Umar just vanished one day. Maybe she were killed, maybe not. But every century or so, it is said she comes back to the hills." Willet says, "Ha ha, this is where it gets right funny, your story. I'm warning you, boy. You'll be out on your arse faster than you can blink if you keeps this up." "Ahem. As I said, every century or so, she comes again. People disappear, tortured in the hills, and only sometimes are the bodies found. Once Umar sated herself on blood, she returns to when she came. This is just like them other times. People forget so easily. 'Tis the witch, I tells you." "Has nobody tried to find this witch in recent years?" "Well, there was a group of mages some years back who came. Young ones, apprentices, I gathered. Two fellas and a young lass, sure enough. They were sent out by their master to look into the Umar witch, or so they said. Nice enough group, but 'twere obvious they expected nothing." Willet says, "I remember him. They were all right, for mages. Lots nicer than that Germian fella. Now he should go and soak his head." "Aye, true enough. Them three went into the hills, and they was never found again. Except for the lass's journals. I found those myself, out in the woods. More victims of Umar herself. Sure as daylight. You can read it in the lass's journal, sure enough." "Do you think I might be able to take a look at this journal?" "Aye, you can. I had a copy or two, or 30, done up by a scribe friend of mine some months back. You can have one if you likes." Willet says, "A copy or two? More like you got a whole storeroom full of copies of that journal, you bleeding banana." "Well, so what if I have? 'Tis a good story, more or less. Make me bloody rich one day. And then where will you be, you little rugrat?" Willet says, "More like you wrote the journal yourself, I'd wager." "I did not such thing. Here you go, my lady. Use it as you will, but beware the witch, if you goes into the hills. She's not sated yet, not by a long shot." Alright, so we got another journal, which I assume is the same. Okay. Oh, wait. Might as well keep them together. Alright, we still need a rest, so... "Ah, 'tis good to see you again, my lord. Is there something I can do for you?" It's the same thing. "You watch your tongue, you long-eared vermin, or I'll cut it off. Now, my lord, since you don't re-want me stories, was there aught else I could do for you?" I've not many rooms, mind you. All the frightened folk who fled into the village have near filled me up. Only a room or two left. Well, it says, just don't mind the rodents while you're sleeping. Silence, boy. There were no foulsome rodents here other than you. Now, my lord. It does say if you're sure you want to rest. But this time we got the actual room animation. Okay. Well, I thought... He's talking about an attic, but I don't see any way to get up to any other floor. Well, at least it's daytime out.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Well, we have the ranger cabin, Jeremian's home, and the rest of this area to explore. But that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.